Good morning, Conroe, Texas, and Montgomery County, Texas. You got Nathan Arizotti of Montgomery County Lifestyle. This is our first show, the inaugural show, the Mac Daddy, Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. And I just want to tell you, I am excited. I got goosebumps, kind of got little butterflies in my belly over here, but I am excited to be here. And I want to thank each and every one of you, because I wouldn't be sitting here with some wonderful guests that I have this morning, some wonderful guests that I'm going to be having every single Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, if it wasn't for your support of what I want to bring to the community. And that is real simple: to bring the community to you, the community. So I'm going to have to give a special shout out and a hello. He's normally quiet, to Dick Schistler. Hello, Dick. Look, he didn't even have the radio, the microphone ready.
Good morning.
Folks, Dick Schistler, Lone Star Community Radio, has been around quite a while. You need to go to his Facebook page. You need to go to the website. You need to learn about Lone Star Community Radio. It's not just about playing music. It's not just about having a few talk shows. It's the same thing. It's called Lone Star Community Radio because it is about the community, talking about the community, needs in the community, interesting businesses, interesting people in the community, and when there's needs and organizations and people that need something, this is one of the first places to start. So thank you, Dick, for the opportunity. And if you're listening and you've always wanted to be on the show, you've got a topic, you're an interesting person, you've got a friend or you've got a business that you want the community to know about, you need to get a hold of me. You need to go to the Facebook page, Montgomery County Lifestyle, and send me a message. You need to send me an email, and you can send that, if it has to do with the radio, at nathan@irlonestar.com. And let me know that you want to be on the show. Let me know about somebody interesting. Let me know about your business, your organization. We're going to have several shows. We're going to have some commissioner's corners. We're going to talk to the Montgomery County commissioners at different times, kind of a state of the office. We're going to talk to city councilmen and the mayor, what's going on in the community. We're going to talk to policemen. We're going to talk to law enforcement. We're going to talk to people in the district attorney and the judges. We want to know about all that. But the meat and potatoes is I need to know what you, the community, want to hear about and what you want to discuss and what you need to know. So that's kind of that in a nutshell. I will tell you that this is the first week, the first day. So today we're going to have Cindy Hedeman, who wrote a book called Bill Is No Bully. We're going to talk about how I got to know her and the book and why that is so important, and especially today. We're going to talk to a young man by the name of Benny Cude. Benny Cude is got a lot of things. He's got a lot of background business. But what brought us to meet and what I'm just tickle pink about is championship bull riding. Yeah, those 2,000-pound four-legged beasts that absolutely will throw a man 15 feet in the air, and if you don't get up and get running, they're going to stomp all over you. We're going to talk about that. Mayor Pro Tem Duke Kuhn is supposed to be meeting us here, and also Mrs. Montgomery County Misti Jeter. Today is about bullying, the problems that it causes in our schools. There's bullying in an adult way, too. We see that a lot, especially when it comes to politics. We've seen that over the past couple of years, people that don't agree with each other. You don't like my side, you don't like my story, I'm going to bully you to try to shut you up. So it can start at a young age and go a whole lifetime. And then tomorrow, we're going to have Ms. Amanda Bond, the director of the Golden Girls, with Cindy Hawkins, and Marlene Stubler, owner of Pie in the Sky. And if Marlene's listening, I do like pecan pie, not pecan, but pecan pie. So if you want to bring that tomorrow, Marlene, you can. And we'll also have brand new Constable Precinct 1, Mr. Philip Cash. He will be in to talk about what's going on, initiatives and things like that. So, folks, again, I'll wrap up me talking. I'll say thank you. And we're going to be back in just 1 minute. We're going to have Cindy Hedeman, author of Bill Is No Bully, and Benny Cude of Championship Bull Riding. Stay tuned, folks. Got a great story coming.
Lone Star Community Radio is FM. That's right. Set your radio dials and your button presets to Conroe's FM 104.5 and 106.1, coming in June of 2016. To celebrate this edition and the addition of video versions of our talk and music shows on YouTube, cable TV, and Our City TV, we are offering special sponsorship rates, which include free audio spots that are played throughout our broadcast. Interested? Check out our sponsor rates for shows just like the one you're listening to online at irlonestar.com/sponsor, or call the station at 936-647-5747. Reaching the people of Montgomery County with Montgomery County's community radio station with Lone Star Community Radio.
Well, folks, we are back to our first show ever of Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. Thank you for tuning in and listening. This will also be out on a podcast in 24 hours, and it'll also be on YouTube so you can watch the radio show. Folks, I've got in the studio with me, I've got Cindy Hedeman, Benny Cude, Championship Bull Riding. Cindy, we're going to dive right in. You are the author of a wonderful book called Bill Is No Bully. First of all, thank you for being here, and tell me a little bit about yourself and our listeners and about the book.
Well, thanks for having me. I'm a school teacher. I've taught for 34 years. I teach in Bowie, Texas. I teach 3rd through 5th grade, and the Bill Is No Bully book is probably gauged to that age and younger, because that's the age kids that I work with.
So let me back up real quick. You said Bowie, Texas. I know where that is now, but our people don't know. Where is that compared to Montgomery County, Texas?
We're about 4.5 hours north. We're between Fort Worth and Wichita Falls.
And how many people live there?
About 5,000. It's the 3A district. I have about 400 kids at our school. We're 3rd through 5th.
So you got 5,000 people that live there, and there's 75 or 80,000 in Conroe.
Yes.
Wow. Wow. So you've been a school teacher 34 years.
Yes. I taught 2 years in Arizona, and I've been in Texas for 32 years.
That's incredible. That's hats off to you. You are a public servant when it comes to that. What was the idea behind the book?
Well, the idea behind the book, it originally started Gary had decided that he would take Bill, who actually, Bill was raised down here in Shepherd. He's actually owned by Alexis and Joe Bradford that live in Shepherd, Texas. And we had seen Bill through some friends and what a big gentle giant he was. And so Gary had said, why don't you think of some kind of story, like when I take Bill out for promotions or whatever, that I could tell the kids or whoever about Bill being a bully. So that's how the story originated. And then my sister-in-law, who works with Championship Bullring a lot, she said, yeah, you need to write the book. You need to write it right now. You need to do the pictures, and, you know, we need it done now. And so it kind of snowballed.
So let me back up. For those of you that didn't catch on, Bill is a bull. Benny, I'm going to bring you in. How much do you think Bill weighs?
On any given day, I would say he's pushing 1,900 pounds.
Folks, we're talking about a 2,000-pound bull who is a gentle giant. Does he even know how to, well, he's a bull, so he could buck if he wanted to. But has he ever been one of those bulls that came out of the chutes just going crazy, snorting and snotting? And
he was bred to be a world-class bucking bull, but he never had any tendency to buck.
So he's like Ferdinand.
He was just a just a pet.
So you use Bill, because if anybody could be a bully, it would be a 2,000-pound bull.
Yes.
And so that's just almost a God-given thing for that just to fall in your lap, so to speak, because a kid can associate with that. They can look at that bull and be scared, but then now you're making that big old bull, that bully, nothing.
Yeah, then he's not scary. You know, and I did research, and I looked at anti-bullying strategies for kids, you know, like if they're in a situation, what are you supposed to do? And so I try to incorporate that into the story. So, like, what would Bill do? What would you do? And so that kind of all got incorporated into the story also.
So give us a quick little synopsis of some of the pieces of the book, some of the storyline.
Well, the storyline is basically about Bill and that he's different. Or, you know, so, you know, when everybody's different, that makes him a target. And so it talks about how, you know, he stood up for himself and his friends and, you know, and to have tolerance for people that are different, or, you know, things that aren't, don't go your way. And, you know, to really be a upstander versus a bystander, you know, that's important. You know, being a bystander, you know, it's easy to be a bystander and watch something go on, but it's hard to be an upstander and stand up for what's right. And so I try to incorporate that in there also.
I don't think I've ever heard that term. I like that, upstander.
It was used a lot. Actually, my Gift and Talented class I took to the Holocaust Museum in Dallas, and that was a big word used there, as, you know, when the Holocaust was going on, is, you know, the bystanders were brought to the concentration camp to say, look, this is what happens because you're a bystander. You need to be an upstander. So that's where, you know, I kind of took that term from the, you know, the Holocaust Museum and our visit there.
So what year, when did you write the book? When did you start writing it?
We wrote it, it's been...
14, maybe 13, yeah, 14.
It was in the fall of 14. We actually came to, I'd written the story, and we had kind of a prototype, and we actually came to Benny, and Benny just jumped on board and said, that's a great idea, we need to do something. So he's been a supporter of the book from the very beginning.
So let's tie in, listeners, we're going to go to Benny Cude, owner of Championship Bull Riding, real quick. Benny, what was it about the book and the story? Why did you want to get involved?
It's something that's needed, and it's something that's dealt with on a daily basis in our school systems, and as you pointed out, in adult life. But if we can do something at a young level, maybe we can prevent some of the society's problems that we have today with people being bullied. And I thought the scheme of the bull and the story of Bull, Bill the No Bully, was awesome way to reach the kids. And of course, we had the venue to help Gary and Cindy promote it, and they've done tremendous with it. They've reached a lot of kids, a lot of schools. Now, of course, we're not satisfied. We would like something miraculous to happen with the input that we're getting from the city of Conroe and the Conroe School District. It's one of the biggest school districts in the state of Texas, and we are so delighted that we've been given a check mark and an approval from a major school district. So maybe we can continue to go into, we'll go anywhere that we can help stop this problem. And this bull is a phenomenal way to reach these kids. When these kids look fear in the face and they can kiss that bull on the nose or scratch him or crawl on his back, wrap their arms around him, love this bull, they know that they can fight that fear that they face every day.
And I tell you, when the championship bull riding was here in October and you had Bill the Bull up at Heritage Plaza, and that was when I got to meet you, and Mayor Pro Tem Duke Kuhn was out there. We had the book. We had some kids show up. It was a school day, so we didn't get that many kids. But we had some kids, and like you said, they could kiss him on the nose. They could touch his face. And, guys, I was there. We're talking a 2,000-pound beast. He looked scary. And then we put him on the back. Mm-hmm. And Tara Garcia, got to give a shout-out to her, Tara Garcia, who works for State Senator Brandon Creighton. Mm-hmm. She climbed on the back of old Bill. And it was great. It was wonderful. In fact, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back later today and I'm going to share some of those pictures on Montgomery County Lifestyle. And we're going to revisit those pictures. And I want people to see the people with Bill. I want people to see Bill. I want them to see the book. And I want to see the kids interacting with them. Yeah, I'm going to throw in a picture or two of Mayor Pro Tem Duke Kuhn riding Bill. We'll see if I show the pictures of him falling off or getting bucked off. But you're right. Kids grow up and want to be a football player, baseball player, rocket scientist, politician. Kids grow up and they want to be a cowboy. Boys and girls want to be a cowboy. So for you to take that and incorporate it into bull riding, that's who you want sitting in your audience anyway, right? You want the families there, don't you? And some of those kids probably got that going on. And so you have an opportunity to bring that in. So what kind of response have you seen so far?
Oh, it's been a great response. As of, I think in the fall of the beginning of this year, I mean, Bill's seen over probably 15,000 kids.
Wow.
So, you know, the message is getting out there, and that's, you know, he's been to several states. I know last year at the Bossier event, you know, that's a very, it was a very urban area, and those kids absolutely loved Bill. I mean, Gary called me and said he's had more hugs and kisses here than he's had any day in his life. So, you know, it's definitely, you know, the kids love it when we get him there and get the message out. So, you know, and it just goes hand in hand, you know, bull and championship bull riding.
Right.
He's kind of not really the mascot for championship bull riding, but, you know, it sure fits well hand in hand.
Awesome. Folks, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to talk a little bit more about championship bull riding, what it is, what it means to Montgomery County, because that's where they're based out of, where they go, how you can get involved. And then I want to hit a little bit more, Cindy, with you too, as far as where you want to see this go and what you want to see happen with your book. Folks, you're listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. We'll be back in just a minute.
Want to check out what it's like to be on the radio? Need credit for school? For an internship? Then contact Dick online at dick@irlonestar.com. Lone Star Community Radio is Montgomery County's community radio station, and we are here to be part of the community.
All right, folks, you are back. You are listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. And by the way, I got to give a shout out. How do you like that music? That is Ezra Charles from Houston Tech. Well, he's from Beaumont, lives in Houston. Ezra Charles in the works, been around, God, a long time. That is Mr. Texas Boogie Woogie, and that's me. You're not going to have any hip-hop on here. There ain't no Beyonce on here, and, you know, there'll be some country, but Boogie Woogie. Folks, we're back. We have Cindy Hedeman, author of Bill Is No Bully. We have Benny Cude, owner of Championship Bull Riding. If you've been listening, you know we're talking about bullying and a push to anti-bully, to be an upstander. I learned a new word. You can be a bystander and let things happen, and aren't you proud of yourself, or you can be an upstander, take a stand, and protect those maybe that they can't protect themselves. So, Cindy, where we left off, here's what I want to do. We've got about 7 minutes or so. Talk about where your partnership with Championship Bull Riding has taken the book and your message. And then where do you want it to go? What are some wishes? What do you want to see happen?
Well, I mean, Championship Bull Riding has been a big benefit to us because they've given us a foot in the door to these different communities and to bring Bill's story and the anti-bullying message. Most schools have to have, it's a law that you have an anti-bullying program. You know, so we'd like to see, you know, other school districts shout out to us and get, you know, get involved with the Bill Is No Bully program or try to schedule. I'm an educator. I know scheduling is difficult. So, you know, but you can, you know, get in touch with Championship Bull Riding or myself. He's got a Facebook page and try to, you know, get Bill's message out there, you know, that, you know, the anti-bullying is, you know, out there and we want it to stop. We want bullying stopped.
So I guess that's twofold that go together. You'd like to see your book picked up by school districts. You'd like to see the book picked up because it's kind of the intermediate or the elementary school age.
It's elementary age, yes.
So it's a book for the kids to look at and associate with and maybe give them some power, give them some motivation to speak up and not go hide in the shadows and not just be quiet and go hide. And to give them some confidence possibly, you know?
Yeah, and some ideas of who do I turn to? You know,
right.
That's in the book. Who can help me if I'm having a problem? You know, so I think the book does a pretty good job for the elementary age kids of giving them some strategies of who and what to do if they're being bullied. The book is, I'm really proud of it. I did the illustrations too. So and we incorporated it. It's kind of fun because if you know championship bull riding, some of the famous bulls that have been out there in the rodeo world are kind of, you know, it is a fiction book, but they've been incorporated into the story as well. So
then that goes back over to you, Benny, championship bull riding. So it's one thing to get the book in the schools. We can't get the message other than just making phone calls and emails and whatever. But now the bull, with Bill traveling with the rodeo and other things, now we can get him into the schools, hopefully. And it's something bigger to put your hands on than a book. Now we've got a living, breathing animal that people want to see and touch. So how do you see you, Championship Bull Riding, taking that message to the next level?
Well, championship bull riding is a culture that we want to give back when we come into a community. We don't want to be just a circus that comes to town, gets the community's money and leave. We want to make a positive impact. And I can't think of anything that is more valuable than this bully program. And if we can continue to, with help with guys like you, Cindy and Gary have come up with something that is amazing. I mean, this can be life-changing for so many children. And if we can just do our part to help bring Bill to the events in the cities and the towns that we go to, it makes us a better company. It makes us a steward of helping people, not just taking, but helping people. And that's what we want to do at Championship Bull Riding.
I got to tell you, I was there that night, folks. It was incredible. The families that were there, it wasn't just guys or girls. It was families, and it was kids. And the excitement on these kids' faces and stuff like that, it's wonderful. So I got to throw a plug to Championship Bull Riding. Wonderful lady, Sherry Morgan, over at the Convention and Visitors Bureau, she brought me into this kind of at the last minute to kind of help promote that Mayor Pro Tem Duke Coon was going to ride a bull and get to meet Bill the Bull and the book and everything. And I thought that was cool. But a couple of things happened. I got to meet the bull, and I got to meet you, Benny, and Leanne and Kylie and Gary, and you're just so gracious. You're so humble. You're just a dude. You're just a mother. You're just people. Okay? You don't make yourself, you're not up on a pedestal. And you really wanted to get a message out there. And then I read the book. I took the book home and I read the book. And it made a difference in me. I don't think I was ever bullied that I know of. As an adult, I've been bullied. But I remember some kids, and I know it made me remember some times where I've seen friends or friends' kids or heard stories. And you're right. You go hide. You just take yourself out of the picture and go away. So if one kid is touched or family is helped, that's incredible. And that night was power, and it was dynamite, and it was crazy. So how, when you come back in October, Benny, how can we take her book? What are some things we can do to make it bigger here in Conroe, Montgomery County, and then the school district? I want to call out my good friend Melanie Bush, who is CISD school board member. Scott Kidd, school board member. Hello, I went to high school with you, dude. And then Dr. Stockton and Dr. Null, Dr. Weatherly over at Conroe High School, Dr. Benson over at Conroe High School. They love our kids. How can we challenge them to get something done? What can we do?
Well, let me first say, Nathan, that Sherry Morgan probably does not get the credit that she deserves.
Ooh, she does not.
She's the quarterback of this program working, and we have the opportunity to do some things. I don't know what we're going to do, but Sherry's very talented, and we're going to work with her. Leanne is talking to her. Kylie's talking to her. Cindy, we're going to make 2017 Conroe event spectacular, and we're going to do something really super with Bill the Bull.
So what are some ways you think we can get the school board involved? What are some things? I think if there's any way we can make it logistics, let's throw it out there. Let's see if we can get Bill the Bull to a Conroe High School football game. If there's a football game that weekend that bull riding's going on, let's figure out a way to get Bill there. Let's promote it in advance. If you're listening and you like this idea, and you want to be involved, you want to be an upstander, then you need to visit Montgomery County Lifestyle Facebook page and send me a message. You need to contact Sherry Morgan at the Convention Bureau. You need to go to Championship Bull Riding Facebook page. Send a message to Benny. Bill is no bully has a Facebook page. Go send them a message. Come on, step it up right now. Let's see what we can do and get Bill to your business, get Bill to a high school game. I don't know what that looks like. I don't know if it's a sponsorship. I don't know if we got to get a hold of one of the car dealers or something. But let's make 2017 in October huge. Let's reach more kids than we ever thought we could. And you know what? There might be some adults that are living with something 10, 20, 30, 40 years ago. There might be some adults that this could be healing to them as well, too.
Absolutely.
So what do you think?
I think it's a challenge. We're up to it.
Cool. Folks, I want to say thank you to Cindy. Cindy, tell everybody how they can get a hold of you and give more information about your book.
Well, you can go to Villas Nobili's Facebook page. The book is also available on Amazon. It's actually self-published through CreateSpace. So any of you, you know, aspiring authors, check CreateSpace as well, because it was very reasonable and, you know, easy to do. So that would be the best way to do it.
Okay, and Benny?
CBRBull.com.
CBRBull.com. Outstanding. Folks, you've been listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. Cindy Hedeman, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
Benny Cude, thank you for being here.
It's our pleasure.
Folks, when we come back, we're going to keep talking about anti-bullying, and I'm going to keep talking a little bit about championship bull riding.
Lone Star Community Radio is FM. That's right. Set your radio dials and your button presets to Conroe's FM 104.5 and 106.1, coming in June of 2016. To celebrate this edition and the addition of video versions of our talk and music shows on YouTube, cable TV, and Our City TV, we are offering special sponsorship rates, which include free audio spots that are played throughout our broadcast. Interested? Check out our sponsor rates for shows just like the one you're listening to online at irlonestar.com/sponsor or call the station at 936-647-5747. Reaching the people of Montgomery County with Montgomery County's community radio station with Lone Star Community Radio.
Again, you're listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. We're back in the studio. We have Mr. Benny Cude of Championship Bull Riding, and somebody just joined us, Mrs. Montgomery County, Misti Jeter. Good morning. How you doing?
Hi, good morning.
Good. Thanks for being here. Folks, we're going to get with Misti in a little bit, talk about Misti Jeter, Mrs. Montgomery County, things that she does. She's also an advocate for anti-bullying, and she's spearheading some things up here in Conroe, but we want to go back and finish with Benny. Benny, dig in a little deeper. Tell us a little bit more about championship bull riding. Not so much the Bill is No Bully, but just championship bull riding. What is it? How long you been around? What's going on?
Championship bull riding was formed in 2002. It is a nationwide standalone bull riding tour. It's on Fox Sports, and we feature 24 to 30 of the best bull riders in the world, some of the best bulls in the world. Our ambassador and front guy is Tough Hedeman, four-time world champion bull rider, Pro Rodeo Hall of Fame, Bull Riding Hall of Fame, movie 8 Seconds, just does a great job for us.
So 24 to 30 of the top bull riders. What if somebody hasn't been to an event? That's what I want to hit. If somebody hasn't been to a professional bull riding event, walk us through what they're going to see. Paint a picture, because I think there's a lot of people that haven't seen it that would just, they'd be hooked. You'd have them hook, line, and sinker.
Well, we like to say that championship bull riding is a combination of a rock and roll concert, a heavyweight prize fight, and a bull riding all rolled into one. A lot of music, a lot of pyro, a lot of excitement, high energy. We have some of the top sound people, the top lighting people, always a lot of big screens where the crowd can see. They can not only see the event as it takes place, but they see the replay. And with the music and the excitement and enthusiasm, it's just a great atmosphere to be in.
I've been to several events, but the championship bull riding this past October was my first here with CBR. Folks, just picture this. We're in Conroe, Montgomery County, so a lot of you grew up here and you remember the old days of the state prison rodeo up there in Huntsville and everything, and them with some good old cowboys up there wearing them stripes. Okay, take that and do 180 degrees turn on that. And like Benny said, we're talking about pyrotechnics of epic proportions. We're talking about a 4th of July show inside of an arena. I don't know if it's gasoline or what, probably some secret ingredient, but we're talking about the dirt gets on fire. I mean, it's incredible. It is a show, and the music, and it's pumping, and it's loud, and you're pumped up, and you're good. And then all of a sudden, you got 2,000 pounds throwing somebody around like a rag doll, and two or three what we used to call rodeo clowns, but they're bullfighters there to protect them. I mean, it's insane. It's I don't even, your insurance salesman loves you, doesn't he?
He does. He does. and he gets paid monthly. But the crowd in the seat, you know, a lot of the perception is that you walk in and the gates open and there's the bull rider. But our shows are choreographed down to the minute. Of course, they have to when they're televised. So everything works in tandem, in sync, and you know we practice to produce those kind of shows, and you know we're just delighted to be able to come to cities like Conroe and bring back some of the glory days when Conroe was a Western town,
mm-hmm.
and rodeo was something that was on everybody's calendar every year, and it was a destination. And we are just so thankful that the city of Conroe has backed championship bull riding and steps up and is our sponsor to bring us back here.
Well, you've got an event this weekend going on in Lufkin. Tell us about that, because that's, what, 2-hour drive?
It's about 2 hours north of here on Highway 59. Take 242 over to 59. Just stay north 2 hours, you're in Lufkin, Texas. But we have an event this Saturday night, which is the 28th year of the Lufkin Bull Bash. Championship Bull Riding produces and promotes the four oldest freestanding bull ridings in existence. And Lufkin, Texas is the second oldest, which is 28 years.
Wow.
So if you want to get a taste of what's going to be in Conroe in October, come out to Lufkin. You'll see one of the greatest, exciting bull ridings ever.
Well, we've got a lot going on in Conroe, Montgomery County, but folks, if you want to get a taste, like he said, head over to Lufkin. In the meantime, to find out more about CBR, you said cbrbull.com. There's also Championship Bull Riding Facebook page. And what do you know the dates that you'll be back in October?
It's the first weekend of October.
First weekend in October, you will be here out at the Lone Star Fairgrounds, and it's a Saturday night event. I know that you're working and your team is working with Sherry and some other people in Conroe to try to bring some special, side events or special add-ons to the bull riding that night. So, folks, you need to make plans. First weekend in October, go to cbrbull.com. You're on Fox Southwest, right?
Or Fox Sports and Fox Sports Net, yes.
Fox Sports and Fox Sports Net. Find out more about championship bull riding. Find out more about how they're tied into anti-bullying and get involved and have some fun. Benny, what else?
Nathan, we thank you so much for having us. This is your inaugural show, and we're just delighted to be part of it.
Well, I'm proud that you are part of it. I really felt close when I got to meet you guys. This is something that's near and dear to my heart. So we're going to take a quick break. Benny, thank you for being here. When we come back, we're going to have Misti Jeter, Mrs. Montgomery County. So, folks, come on back. Stay tuned.
We're starting to film our talk shows and putting them on YouTube. Your favorite Lone Star Community Radio show can be seen on YouTube under our Lone Star Community Radio channel and on City of Conroe's Our City TV channel on Suddenlink Channel 12. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel to see the most recently released videos and find more information online at irlonestar.com/TV.
Good morning, folks. You are back to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti here on Lone Star Community Radio. You can be listening to us live, local FM 104.5, 106.1. You can listen worldwide at www.irlonestar.com. We will be having a podcast out within a day after the show, and these are YouTube, so you'll be able to look at the radio show later too. Folks, today is our first day, our inaugural show. We've had a good morning so far. I thank you to the listeners. I thank you to those that will share this when it comes out. Tell your friends. We want to talk about the community. I want to bring the community community and all that it has to offer, be it business, be it organization, be it a need, something we can learn to you. So that being said, I have with me now Mrs. Montgomery County Misti Jeter, and I also have Sherry Morgan of the Convention Bureau. And what we're doing is we're talking about the problem, kind of the silent problem of bullying and what it does to a person, what it does to financially to a school district. Sherry Morgan has been extremely involved with Championship Bull Riding, and Cindy Hedeman, who was speaking earlier about the book, Bill is No Bully. And it's a passion of hers that she can help. And help, we've all agreed, if we help one kid, one person, then we've done our job. However, let's go big. Let's go all out. Let's see if we can help everybody. So, Misti, thanks for being here. Tell us a little bit about you, Mrs. Montgomery County, and then we'll work our way into talking about why this anti-bullying campaign is important to you.
Sure. So I am your current Mrs. Montgomery County. I am your local representative for Mrs. Texas America. I will be competing the first week in May for the Mrs. Texas title, which is a predecessor to Mrs. America. And then Mrs. America goes to Mrs. World. So as you can see, there's quite a bit of competition left in this season.
So, Mrs. Montgomery County, when did you earn that title? When did you win that?
I believe it was last October.
Okay.
So it's appointed. You go through a process. Tracy Christ is an amazing director, and we compete. Texas has about 50 girls that compete for the title.
Wow. And then you're going for, you said, Mrs. Texas?
Uh-huh. At Mrs. Texas, 50 contestants in Corsicana, May 4th through 6th. We have prelims, and we have finals. And I can tell you it is the hardest, most amazing weekend ever. It's truly very difficult to compete with yourself and move the needle for you and who you are and work on things that you know are your weakness. And it's not just, you know, what are you eating? Are you working out? You know, do you have a great smile? It has to do with interpersonal, intrinsic metrics that, you know, you yourself have to work on. And that's really what showcases that weekend.
Wow. So you've got a lot of work ahead of you, like to do. So we'll talk a little bit how people can follow you. Well, let's throw them out now. Do you have a Facebook page?
I do have a Facebook page.
So how can they follow you and cheer you on?
It's Mrs. Montgomery County, Misti Jeter. You can follow me on Facebook. I do all kinds of promotions, community involvement. I'm a two-time breast cancer and thyroid cancer survivor. So I am always out and extremely busy. And when I'm bored or my sanctuary, my thinking spot, you can find me at the Conroe Animal Shelter. I get to pet kittens and walk puppies, so it's a lot of fun.
I follow her on Facebook, folks, and I've seen that. She's very involved in a lot of community events. She's very involved in the cancer events. A lot of you out there will say the name Misti Jeter, Misti Jeter. Yep, you know her. You've seen her. She's well-known, but she wants to be more well-known with bullying. So now let's tie that in. Why this? Why the subject of bullying?
You know, I can remember back to sixth grade. My family, I grew up here in Houston, born and raised, and we moved to Colorado. And my first experience in my new school, the most popular, cute guy walks up to me, kind of says hi, and I said hi back. And he looks at me and kind of had this like weird face, and he said, "You look like a Smurf." That was my introduction to my new school, my sixth grade year in a new state, a new city with a bunch of people that I had no idea who they were. And it wasn't necessarily that he meant anything specific by it, but it was just a way for him to distinguish whether I was accepted or not. And that carried my entire experience in Colorado.
So he put a label on you, whether he knew it or not, and now you had a label.
Absolutely.
And you wore that label and you kept that label,
of course.
Other people did see it or not.
Absolutely. Your psyche, everything that happens to you that's an influence from you or of you or by you, it affects how we move, how we see, how we act, and how we affect change. That year I changed. I went from being a VIC, you know, great grades, had my own little club of friends that, you know, hung around our neighborhood, into a different person. I was more reserved in school. I started making not so good grades just because of that influence where I suddenly lost that sense of accomplishment, sense of confidence that everything that I would be motivated to achieve, I didn't care anymore.
Wow. So do you think you've come back from that? And if so, what are some things that brought you back? Because we mentioned earlier that there's probably some adults that are carrying some baggage from something that happened in third grade, fourth grade, fifth grade, sixth grade.
Absolutely. It takes years of going back and looking back and trying to find a systemic point in time that could have radiated all types of symptoms from it. You know, that's just one small thing that one kid said to me in my life. You know, and I'm out in the community every day, you know, every weekend. We're constantly doing stuff. So I can only imagine how many words I've said that have influenced change in other people. So for growing up through high school, junior high, we came back to Texas. I graduated from Montgomery High School. Go Bears. And for me, it's seeing my kids that are going through bullying and how schools have changed and how we are so, I guess, just wrapped up in technology that it's so easy for the victims to be real victims, even with cyberbullying, and not even see, it's not a face-to-face encounter anymore. So we're fighting bullying on a brand new front. You know, a kid doesn't walk up in the schools so much as they do tweeting, and they do Instagram, and they make fun of people, and it reaches thousands or hundreds of thousands of people, adults, children, doesn't matter. So bullying does not discriminate.
I'm going to jump over to Sherry Morgan. Sherry Morgan's a friend, and she is with the Convention and Visitors Bureau here in Conroe. You're shaking your head.
Mm-hmm.
What thoughts do you say something? Tell me.
Oh, the power of social media is really beyond our comprehension, and that power can be used for good or it can be used for evil, and all too often, you know, the safe place for a lot of people, it's easy to point out people's differences. The challenge comes in finding out our common denominator. But it's easy when you're a kid, if you're trying to bolster yourself, step on somebody else, and then your audience is massive, like Misti was saying. I mean, the audience is built in, and it's right there. And then that stuff spreads exponentially because it's salacious, and it's, oh, did you see this? And people want to talk about it, and it's disheartening because you'd like to think that with all the technology that we have that we'd be doing something better with it. And we can. It's not too late to change this narrative, and it's through programs like Bill Is No Bully and platforms like Misti on the stages that she's representing it on and out in the community. The power is ours. All we have to do is take action. And like Cindy said, we need to start being those upstanders and not bystanders. And showing through our daily walk and our daily talk what our values are and who we are. And if we want to settle on being bullies, nameless, faceless bullies, then that's a sad indication of who we are, but we're better than that.
Well, and I think, unfortunately, we've been headed that way for several years for a lot of things. I think technology makes it easy.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was going to happen anyway. But I think the political scene, worldwide and in the U.S., and then all the way down here to Montgomery County and Conroe, we've seen it okay. We've seen the left blow up the right. We've seen the right blow up the left. I hate Donald Trump. I love Donald Trump, so I hate you. One side says, oh, they're so unforgiving, they won't. But yet, this side does the same thing, just differently. And we've seen it here locally. Look, I'm not going to call it any names, but I'm done with it. There's adults here that use that Facebook or use some other fake blog narrative to blow up. And they might have a good story. And they might have a good cause. And they might really want to affect some change. But the way they do it is breaking down people besides just that one person they go after. The families, the kids, the people on the side. And I think Brett Ligon said it a couple of years ago best, and I've thought it, but now I really, really take it to heart. You've got a vocal minority keeping the silent majority silent because they don't want to get bullied. They don't want to get involved. So we've become a bystander. Instead of me taking a little heat or a lot of heat, I'm just going to let you keep mouthing over there to Sherry because I don't want to get involved.
Well, so while we as adults are participating in this political display, right? Mm-hmm. What are your kids seeing? You know, at the coffee shop, at the Starbucks, at the school, at, you know, at home. What are your kids seeing? That is what they are emulating mm-hmm. out in society. They're little mini-me's, right? So what are your kids doing? When they go to school and some kid has a, like you said, a Trump shirt, well, where does that attack happen? That attack happens at the scene. It happens at your school, on the playground. And then you build that aggression, even though he may not have picked that shirt out or she may not have been, you know, picked out the bow or whatever it was, but it became a target that somebody could latch onto and use to, like you said, deflect, right? Mm-hmm. Deflect from them, from whatever trauma, whatever emotional, mental instability that they are going through, and they're able to connect that and move it towards somebody else.
Folks, we're talking with Sherry Morgan of the Convention Visitors Bureau, Mrs. Montgomery County Misti Jeter. We've only got about another minute, so what I'd like to do real quick is, Misti, tell everybody how they can get a hold of you, contact you. We're going to have you back on the show because you want to get pushing a Be Kind initiative. You want to get involved in the school district, and we need to tap on that. And it may coincide with Bill is No Bully. It may coincide with Championship Bull Riding coming back. So how can we get a hold of you? How can we get more help you, and how can you help them?
Go like my Facebook page. Go like it. Tell me how great it is to see me and hear me out on the radio and with Nathan and Sherry out here at Lone Star Radio. So what I actually, if you would message me on Facebook, that would be fantastic. I answer any message that you want. I would love to do appearances. My initiative for for Conroe is that we have a Be Kind system be put into schools, but it's targeting girl against girl bullying. I don't know how many times you're so much more supportive than women. Us ladies, we can be pretty catty, you know, in the PTOs or PTAs and even in the workplace. So I would love to talk more about that.
Awesome. Folks, you've been listening to Montgomery County Lifestyle with Nathan Arizotti. Sherry Morgan, thank you for being here. Misti Jeter, thank you for being here. Folks, we'll be back to wrap it up. Stay tuned.
Thanks for checking out this production of Lone Star Community Radio, Montgomery County's community radio station. For more information on this show and other shows on Lone Star Community Radio, check us out online at irlonestar.com. If you're interested in sponsoring a program on Lone Star Community Radio and reaching the local audience of Montgomery County on FM, internet, TV, media, please call 936-647-5747 or contact us online at irlonestar.com. This recording is a Lone Star Community Radio production produced by the show host and Dick Schischler of Lone Star Community Radio. Interested in volunteering as a music DJ or starting your own talk show? Contact Dick Schischler at dick@irlonestar.com or by phone at 936-647-5747.